This is what we have seen. Now let us see what happens under the rapid change in temperature. So now you will not allow it to equalize. You are going to bring it suddenly. Question is, when can you have a situation when rapid changes in temperature can occur? And you don't give time. So you have your airship in a nice air conditioned hangar and take out suddenly. It will take some time for it to stabilize. During that time, what will happen? That is what we will see now. Similarly, you are flying the airship and suddenly it starts raining. Suddenly you encounter very cold conditions. So during the time when the whole envelope cools down to the ambient condition, it will take, during that time this will be applicable. Similarly, if you are flying on a cold weather, so in the long distance or long endurance flight, the airship can encounter situations where there is a sudden change in temperature without giving the time for the equilibrium to take place. During these cases, there will be a change in the gross and net lift, let us see. So you can look at this problem from two angles. One angle will be there is a change in the gross lift. So let us recall that delta LG or the change in the gross lift is PS times 1 by T A2 minus 1 by T A1 times KV. This we have seen last time. So the net lift difference, I am repeating again, is the gross lift difference and the Bollinger Weyl difference. Okay, I am showing it in same thing as delta LG and delta WBA. Now delta WBA is equal to 0 in this case, because there is no time available for the system to respond and the Bollinger air to go out. Okay, if you give time, then of course system will go into equilibrium, but right now so therefore the net lift change will be equal to the gross lift change. So the net lift, so there will be a change in the lift. This is like you are not allowing the system to respond and suddenly temperature has changed. So therefore net lift will change. It will become 1 upon T A2 minus 1 upon T A1. Now what will happen? Will it reduce or increase if you go to a cold place? If T A2 is less than T A1, what is it? Increase. If you go to a cold place, it will increase. Why? If T A2 is less than T A1, okay, right. One more way of looking at the whole thing is that subjecting an airship to sudden change in the ambient temperature is like giving it a sudden superheat or super cooling, depending on whether you are going into a hot place or a cool place. Okay, so from that angle, look, the expression is there will be a TS virtual component there. So now what we will do is we will assume that TA is constant, but there is superheat applied. Now initially the airship is at TA1 and suddenly it goes at TA2. Therefore the delta TSH1 will be 0 to start with, and that will be suddenly TA1 minus TA2. You can consider it as 0 superheat when you are flying and suddenly you are exposed to a superheat of TA1 minus TA2, because temperature has become TA2 from TA1. Put that in the expression. So you will put it as 1 upon TA2 plus 0 and 1 upon, and ultimately you will get the same expression. So whether you look at it as sudden superheat or you look at it as instantaneous change in TA, the expressions are the same. See, physics will not change just because how you take it. Physics will remain the same. There will be a change in the net lift, but over a period of time when TA1 and TA2 equalize, there will be no change in the net lift, which is the situation for slow change in temperature. Okay. So for a sudden shock change in temperature, there will be a change in the net lift. For a gradual change, the change is 0.